to my channel. Thank you for stopping by. So this is another holiday Christmas inspired look. This time I'm all about the blues. It's more of an unconventional look, but it still ties in with winter because, you know, it's that winter blue type look. I've done this look before. It is on my Instagram page, but I was going through and I saw it and I'm like, I like that look. Let me recreate that look for the holiday, and to make it more holiday friendly, I added a little glitter liner, you know, to spice things up. I mean, guys, I really love glitter. Like, if you haven't known yet, you know now. I really love glitter. I did not do my full face routine in this video. I just focused on the eyes and the little final touches. So I hope you guys are okay with that. I'm gonna do a video that's solely about doing my full face routine. I just need to do, you know, need to have better lighting to really do that, because it doesn't make sense I do it if you guys aren't seeing all the steps. So I am gonna work on that probably for the new year, because right now I'm just focusing on doing Christmas looks for you guys. But yeah, I think I've talked enough, but I hope you guys really enjoyed this video. Please give this video a thumbs up, subscribe if you haven't yet, and I look forward to seeing you in the next one. Until next time, stay beautiful. Bye. Welcome back. So first we're gonna prime our eyes using the Urban Decay eyeshadow primer potion, and I'm just applying that over the eyes and blending it out using my fingers and using that to prime my brows as well and under the eyes. Then I'm gonna take the Wet n Wild eyeliner pencil in the shade Simmer Brow Now, and I'm gonna use that to do my eyebrows today. Yes, you can use a eyeshadow, well, an eyeliner to do your brows. You just have to be more softer and gentler, because it applies more pigment than a regular eyebrow pencil. So I'm just applying that using strokes, and then I'm using a spoolie to just blend that out so that it doesn't look like I apply too much. So to clean up the brows, I'm gonna take the NARS Radiant Creamy Concealer in the shade Amand, and I'm just gonna apply that straight from the tube with the applicator under the brows, and then I'm gonna use a flat shader brush by e.l.f. to, you know, blend that out and make my brows even more sharper, because we were looking for a nice crisp brow. Then I'm using that same NARS concealer in the shade Amand to apply that as my base for my eyeshadows, and I'm gonna blend it out using a Real Technique dome brush and just blending it out so it's nice and smooth, and that making sure there's no creasing. And then I'm gonna set that using just a light translucent powder, tapping that over it, more so in the crease area to help with blending. Going into the Morphe 35O palette, I'm gonna take that shade and apply that as my transitional color, just that it will be easy to blend things. I know it doesn't look like I'm applying anything, but trust me, it's gonna help with blending, especially because I'm using bold colors. Going into the BH Cosmetic 28 Smoky Eye Palette, I'm taking this dark blue shade on the Morphe 1M139 brush, and I'm applying that more so on the outer V area, and then I'm carrying it, blending it up into my crease area going halfway. So I applied most of the shade on the outer section and then blending it upwards, so most of the pigment stays where I need it to stay, and that's in the V area. Then I'm using that first blending brush that we use to just blend the edges to make sure everything is nice and smooth. Going into the Morphe 35B palette, I'm taking this kind of periwinkle blue shade, and I'm applying that on top of where I just applied that shade, and I'm basically mimicking what I did before. In retrospect, I should have used this blue first and then going with the darker blue, but that's not what I did on the opposite eye. So, you know, you have to do the same thing that you did on one eye for the other. So I'm using that same Morphe M139 brush to do this.
And again, as you layer color, you have to go over and blend it just to make sure that it's nice and smooth and, you know, transitional. And this is just me applying some more of that periwinkle blue because we lost some of it in blending. And you'll see me doing that, applying colors, blending and applying it, because as you blend, you lose color. So you kind of have to, it's a back and forth process. So I'm just doing that. And again, blending the edges to make sure everything is seamless. Going into the MAC paint pot in the shade Painterly, I'm going to use a regular art supply paintbrush and just creating kind of a semi-cut crease effect. So I'm just using this to sketch out where I'm going to apply my lid shade and to create that kind of dramatic effect that I want. Going back into the Morphe 35B palette, I'm going to take this light champagne-y beige color, and it's a matte shade, and I'm just using my Sigma E55 flat shader brush to just apply this all over where we just applied that MAC paint pot. And I'm just patting that on. And then I'm going to take my Morphe M139 brush and some more of that periwinkle blue from the Morphe 35B palette, and I'm just blending that to where those two colors that meet to kind of create that gradient effect on the lid space, but not bringing it all the way in. I'm keeping it on the outer thirds of the eyes and also blending some of that into the crease area. And I'm taking my time not to make any of that go into that work that we just did. To deepen the crease area, I'm taking that black from the Morphe 35B palette on a Sigma pencil brush, and I'm just applying that in the crease outer V section. And then I'm going to use the Morphe M139 brush to blend that out a bit so it doesn't look too harsh. And blending. This is a lot of blending. Lots of blending. And again, using that first brush that we laid our transitional shade to just blend the edges to make sure it's nice and seamless. And I'm taking a brush that has no shadow on it, so it's a clean brush, to do like a final blending to make sure everything is nicely blended. I lost some of the color, so I'm just repeating some of the steps of just reapplying colors. That's why I sped up this part. So I'm just really applying some of the colors that I lost, blending it using the brush that we use our transitional shade. So it's a back and forth process again. And I wanted to deepen the crease some more, so I applied a bit more black and I'm blending it out again. Are you guys living for my natural hair twist? Like, I didn't even realize that my hair was looking like that, but oh well, keep it moving. So I'm gonna take my Kat Von D tattoo liner in the shade black, and I'm doing a very tiny line. It's not a wing, it's just a faint line just to help disguise the lash band when I apply my lashes down the line. And then to add some spark, I'm taking the Ruby Kisses Eye Bling Liquid Liner, and this is in a silver shade, and I'm just applying that on top of where I just applied that Kat Von D liner. So I'm doing like a double line. And then I'm applying the L'Oreal Telescopic Mascara in the shade black to my lashes to prep them for the falsies that I'm gonna apply. I'm just tapping on some of that champagne beige color. And for lashes today, I'm taking the Salon Perfect lashes in the style 110. And I'm using my Duo Lash Glue to apply this. And I chose these lashes because it won't hide that little glitter action that I have going on. Because if I use the more thicker one, I think it would hide it. In my waterline, I'm going to use the Wet n Wild Idle Eyes Cream Shadow Pencil, and this is in the shade Electro, and I'm just running that in there. And I'm applying some of that MAC paint pot underneath that to apply as my base for the shadows that I'm going to put so that they can pop. And I'm blending that out using that Real Techniques Dome Brush. First, I'm going to take the Periwinkle Blue from the Morphe M the Morphe 35B palette, and I'm gonna use that M139 brush and kind of blow it out. And then using that deeper blue shade from the BH Cosmetics palette, I'm gonna take that on the pencil brush and apply that closer to the lash line. And then I'm just doing a final mixing of that blending. In the tear duct, I'm gonna go back into that Morphe 35B palette and use this shiny metallic type of shade and apply that there. And then I'm just applying some more mascara on the top and bottom lashes. And then doing one final blending of everything using that clean blending brush. And that is the eyes.
Okay guys, so as you guys can see, I did my face routine off camera because I think you guys have seen me do that enough. So we're just gonna jump into highlighting the face. So first, I've been loving using this before I apply my highlighter. So I'm gonna take my NYX Bright Idea Illuminating Stick, and this is in Sun Kissed Crush. So after we do that, I'm gonna go in with So after we do that, I'm gonna go in with my Laura Geller highlighter, Baked Gelato Swirl Highlighter in the shade Gilded Honey. Apply some of that on my brow bone. After we do that, I'm gonna apply some blush. And for blush, I'm gonna go in with my e.l.f. dark palette, and I'm gonna take this shade right here. We're gonna go into our lip. First, I'm gonna line my lips, and I'm gonna take my NYX lip pencil, and this is in the shade Espresso. Then I'm gonna apply my Milani lipstick, and this is in the shade Pretty Natural. Take my MAC paint pot in Painterly, and I'm gonna take some of that and just dab it in the center of my lips.